alone saw 6 goals, 2 of them netted by the home side. That's the first time Real's been scored upon during their current Asian tour. The final score remained 4-2, with the victory going to the Spanish champions. Here's a look at the highlights.
Some nice passing between Zinedine Zidane and Ronaldo freed Roberto Carlos, who was brought down hard in the box. Despite the objections of the local side, a penalty kick was awarded. Luis Figo stepped up and easily slotted it past keeper Fan Tunip. Then it was on to the Ronaldo show. Here, after some fancy footwork, Ronaldo blasted it past Fan for the second goal of the match. Then the goal that shocked the Spanish football champions, as Wang Peng took a brilliant cross from Li Ming and headed it off Casillas' skull for Hong Kong's first goal. In Real's 2 matches prior to tonight, their goalies had managed to keep clean sheets, and this goal shows that this team of superstars is human. But only just. Real's class was fully demonstrated when they immediately struck back. David Beckham delivered one of his trademark long balls, which just beat the outstretched leg of a defender, cue Ronaldo. Raul got into the act, showing some Real class with his floater to make it 4-1. But to the credit of the Hong Kong Select 11, they got stuck into the superstars from Spain and were rewarded with another goal, this time to Li Rao. That made it 4-2 at the half, with the fans at the stadium simply eating it up. And that's the way it stayed throughout the rest of the match, despite some scoring chances for both sides. After the game, the players from both sides hung around for some photos, and Ronaldo was named the man of the match for his 2 stellar goals.
Real Madrid's visit to Hong Kong finished on a high note with their fans, some of whom waited for hours this afternoon for a shot at good seats. The match finished a little more than an hour ago. Jameson Wong reports.
Still on a high from tonight's game, asked these fans if Real Madrid was worth the money and the wait. Earlier at this bar in Causeway Bay, they would argue this was the place to be.
Yeah, they want to put on a show, and I don't know if it'll boost tourism, but I think it's good enough.
This is once in a lifetime, you know, Real Madrid in Hong Kong. I mean, they've got all those sort of, you know, stars, like with Beckham and Zinedine, Figo. I mean, how often do you get a chance to see that?
Back at Hong Kong Stadium, fans cheered every touch by Real Madrid's superstars. All the big names, Beckham, Ronaldo, Figo, Zidane, Raul, and Roberto Carlos were in the starting lineup. At times, it was hard to figure out which team fans were rooting for. But perhaps the loudest moment came when Hong Kong scored its first goal. Many say finding a side to root for was the easy part. This afternoon, about 1,000 people lined up outside Hong Kong Stadium. Some began queuing up days ago. And when the gates opened hours before the start of the match, they were ready. Beckham fanatic 16-year-old Stanley Lam arrived several hours early, but wasn't worried about how he would pass the time.
He's famous everywhere. I buy this box from England.
But not everyone was caught up in Beckham mania. This fan was actually here to see some good football.
They've got all the top name players around the world, and I want to make sure you can see them. First time I'm going to be able to see them in my life, so I'm excited.
And in the end, fans got all they wanted and waited for. Real Madrid up close and 2 goals by the home team. Jameson Wong, TVB News.
The Secretary for Home Affairs, Patrick Ho, tonight confirmed the ICAC is looking into the distribution of tickets for tonight's Real Madrid match. This follows earlier complaints that many tickets were withheld from sale and some were unaccounted for. These pictures shot by TVB tonight, just before the match, show some women throwing a bunch of tickets into the air, apparently after failing to sell them or even give them away. Jenny Lam has more.
Tickets for tonight's match were still being peddled on the internet hours before kickoff. $500 seats were going for $4,000. When we called the number on the website, we were told tickets were still available outside the stadium. Hong Kong Football Association Chairman Martin Hong says they have been contacted by the ICAC. This followed earlier complaints of unfair distribution of tickets and that some seats are unaccounted for. The ICAC is apparently checking for any inappropriate handling of the tickets, according to Martin Hong, but the anti-graft body would not confirm whether an investigation is underway. Meanwhile, the Football Association has promised...
能够两次攻破皇马的大门，感到既意外又高兴。先由黄文杰讲讲呢场赛事嘅情况。
皇家马德里一开始就排出钻石嘅阵容，三位世界足球先生，是但费高朗拿度，加埋西班牙金童鲁尔、巴西国脚卡路士，同埋万人迷碧咸，全部都系落场。日本超级球星啊，完全冇气场。未够五分钟，卡路士禁区劲射安琪甩手，鲁尔就袭击。不过越位皇马射个炸弧，卡路士咁长喺左边特别抢镜，高出十入禁区，李慧文冇办法，唯有一铲。十二码，费高梗系冇甩拖。 呢个时候只系上半场嘅7分钟，今次朗拿度突破越位，一轮插花之后起脚劲射喺安琪嘅格拉底入网。香港队上半场25分钟逼到角球，李明大脚传中，皇马顶入网。皇家马德里喺亚洲之旅嘅第一次失波，自然唔敢轻敌。33分钟，碧咸嘅准成长传，朗拿度攞都唔攞，就顺先至起脚，安琪又投降。相隔2分钟。 卡路士掟界外球，鲁尔后发先至喺差唔多位置半粒半射，皇家马德里将纪录拉开成4-1。留三球嘅港队完全冇气馁，右键威助攻传中，黄鹏第一脚误入，李瑶保中，港队半场只系落后2-4。皇马华晒都系欧洲嘅超级劲旅，上半场竟然失咗两球，下半场自然加多两前肉紧。朗拿度粒射中未，转头鲁尔见范俊业企咗出嚟，大脚一粒又系中未。 朗拿度抢到单刀，范俊业奋不顾身，几乎撞伤埋朗拿度。皇马攻击都唔入，唯有换班生力军入场。不过范俊业今场大演新加坡，数年嚟心口一空，右脚一吸，就翻只左脚劲射，又俾范俊业挡到。皇家马德里下半场始终冇办法增添入球，结果只系能够赢4-2。亚洲电视记者黄文杰报道。
入场嘅球迷情绪高涨，唔少人都话满意港队嘅表现。喺球赛结束之后，仍然非常之兴奋嘅。由吴子敏讲下，场内40,000个球迷全程投入，欣赏呢场精彩嘅赛事。每当皇马或者港队有攻势，大家都呐喊助威。有入球就更加兴奋。
接近比赛尾声，球迷陆续离开大球场。大家对呢场比赛嘅结果都相当满意，焦点反而系集中喺入咗两球嘅港队身上。
自己系即系香港人定中国人嚟计咧，我应该都好满意噶啦，入到两球波，话晒皇马喺呢个亚洲之旅未入过一球波，未必人入过一球波，所以觉得真系好满意。香港第一波，香港第二波，
已经系赢4粒噶啦，都唔错。
港队咧，
港队更加好啦，都系赢咗波。香港一定得。
散场嘅球迷多到将大球场对开，全部塞满，大家兴奋嘅心情仍然持续。又喺深圳嚟嘅球迷喺场外打锣打鼓，一时间中外球迷打成一片。佢哋话大会唔俾佢哋带锣鼓入场有啲遗憾，但系都好满意赛果。
大连嘅两个球员入咗波啦，跟住香港连队下半场仲未失波咯，都几好，都几好。
横板得你少少遗憾嗰个碑函冇入波咯。咁你觉得你咁样即系咁远喺深圳嚟睇咧，觉得值唔值啊？
一定值噶啦，咁多球员几多年都入唔到噶啦。
几万个观众喺下昼开始已经陆续入场，入场嘅仲有唔少政商界人士。
有冇机会可以破蛋啊？
不过冇飞嘅球迷就帮衬黄牛党，就算波飞比原价贵好多，都有人问价。
见到记者就将啲飞送晒俾其他人。亚洲电视记者吴子敏报道。而香港球员谭伟国咧，赛后获得斯丹嘅球衣噶。
好开心，系咯，即系觉得同斯丹换到衫，好开，特别嘅奖赏啦，佢都冇乜价值咁。佢阅读球赛能力好强，系。
今次嘅表演，赛亦都大旺附近食肆同士多嘅生意。一啲买唔到飞入场嘅球迷，就选择喺酒吧睇赛事，令酒吧嘅生意都大增。陈庆昌报道。
球赛未开始，呢间酒吧已经坐满晒球迷。一有入球，无论系皇马定系港队，球迷都系咁兴奋。
香港隊唔使食光蛋，香港球迷就更加高興。
知唔知道皇馬未識過波嚟？我而家香港都入咗一球喎，係咪先？點啊？香港隊好嘢！
除了酒吧生意好之外，大球場附近一些士多的生意也不錯，老闆入多些貨之餘還加上價，這兩天已經賺多了千多元。
希望捉獎或者每個月搞一場，香港比較旺盛一點，熱鬧一點。
不過有茶餐廳就不敢亂咁加價。
香港的經濟都不好，現在更多人失業，你價錢貴一點就沒人吃了。
為了做多些生意，有茶餐廳更加將飲品放在門口賣，但是賣紀念品的呢，生意就麻麻地，看的人多，買的人少。亞洲電視記者陳慶昌報導。
除了香港大球場近2000人齊集在旺角大球場看賽事的直播，球迷反應熱烈，並且形容球賽是回歸以來香港的最佳代表作。而民政事務局局長何志平就說，足總會在一個月內將皇馬來香港作賽的帳目提交給政府。洪依敏報導。
球场的气氛和政府大球场一样，都是这么高涨，每入一球都引来此起彼落的欢呼声。上半场港队入两球的佳绩，更加将气氛推向高潮。
香港隊入了兩球波，還不滿意？入一球都滿意啦，係咪先？
康文署總共派發了9000張入場券俾市民，最後有接近2000人嚟到呢一度。呢度啲球迷話：喺呢度睇波嘅氣氛比起屋企或者喺酒吧好好多。港隊最後雖然輸了，不過球迷都好滿足。
香港隊好嘢，
係啊，
非常之滿意，
簡直係回歸之後最好嘅傑作，香港嘅最好特區嘅最好嘅傑作。
而在一間大型商場外面，亦都有幾百名市民一起在大電視前面看球賽的轉播。民政事務局局長何志平就說，足球總會會在一個
月歡呼聲以及拍打吹氣棒的砰砰聲都未停過。皇馬六條煙正選上陣，而且大部分仲踢了超過60分鐘，看到啲球迷如痴如醉。當中港聯隊入到波嘅時候，球迷嘅反應就更加熱烈，紛紛將佢哋手上嘅紙扇掟入球場。全場6個入球，咁仲可以睇到碧咸斯丹，球迷覺得值唔值呢？
皇馬都很好，咁個個球員都打得很好，特別是斯丹啦，球技很好，喜出望外。
香港咁意外你可以入到兩球，都算幾好啦。
喺賽後入咗兩球波嘅朗拿度獲選最佳球員，而一班香港球員就好似小球迷一樣，爭住同碧咸影相。皇馬一班副選球員咧喺賽後咧並冇即刻離開㗎，咁仲喺場裏邊咧做一啲簡單嘅訓練。咁現場咧亦都有球迷咧係留低睇㗎。咁而全場獲得最多掌聲嘅斯丹，就聯同教練昆諾斯出席記者會。皇馬星期六會搭早機離開香港，轉往曼谷同泰國國家隊踢亞洲之旅最後一站賽事。有線電視記者馮錦明報導。
賽事結束之後，幾萬個球迷陸續離開，有秩序咁樣係離開㗎。徐月娥報導。
支持香港隊！
斯丹好波！
加油啦！
好
波！
淨係聽球迷嘅回應就知道撲翻嚟嘅波飛係咪值回票價？喺球場入面叫完，散場再嗌過，
真係好波，唔係講笑。嗱，老老實實，呢場波打得真係好。
港隊拼勁好。
幾萬個市民欣賞完比賽，個個都有秩序散場，但係仍然有人唔肯走，希望目睹偶像離開。至於喺旺角場睇轉播嘅球迷就話一樣好滿。